AC 560076, Mary Ann Colt and Alyssa Plummer. Counsel, your appearance and bar number.
Good afternoon, Your Honor. Barrett Grigsby, bar number 10308, appearing for the plaintiff, who's present.
Are you retained, Ms. Grigsby?
Yes, Your Honor.
Let's swear in the parties before we begin.
Please raise your hand. Do you and each of you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give in this action shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Okay, this is paternal grandmother's motion for custody. It's custody, not visitation, right? Custody. Okay, and did mom get a chance to file an opposition? Because I don't think I saw one.
I did. I put it in because I'm filing for former papers.
Do you have an extra copy or no?
No, they told me to put it in.
Oh, this is it?
Yes.
Did you get a copy?
No. I didn't. They said that they put it in your box and said they were going to mail it to me and then send copies and have her.
Oh, we don't do the service. You have to do the service. Okay, so, counsel, please approach.
Okay.
I won't have time to read it. And you need a second to read it, or you just want to go straight to arguments?
If you wish, I can have it served on her today if you give it back to me.
No, she's served right now. Is that it? Copy?
No, it hasn't been filed yet.
Oh, that's hers. Take a look at it, counsel. You need a second? How much of it is briefing? How much of it is briefing? The rest is exhibits. That's all one thing. Or something. FDA. Oh, okay, let me see. Proceed in form of papyrus. Aren't you working?
No, I shattered my arm. They put metal in my arm, and then Sean died, and now I'm doing this. So
you
the best job that I had because we were in court with Sean. I'm not going to go get another job for her to take it away from me. This is ridiculous.
That doesn't help me.
I'm sorry?
Is this your medical records?
That my son was not born on drugs, like she stated, that he's not conformed, he's perfect in every way. I was not in there for 2 weeks, I was in there for 3 days.
How long you been out of work?
Since May. I broke my arm, I got in a car accident, I was working for Uber, and then I shattered my arm in 8 places, and I replaced the whole. Actually, the date that I was supposed to be here the last time was the date that I got the med put in.
That you have what?
It replaced my whole arm.
Oh. You have a doctor's note says that you can't work?
You have it. Oh, no, I can work. I'm just waiting for this to be over. Is this going to be like 4 more years of paternal grandma? My bills are up. My car payment is $700 a month. I pay it every month. I have more than enough in savings to take care of everything for at least another year.
Where'd you get the savings from?
My family and my work and working. I was the project manager at Move for Less. I was making $6,500 a month.
Who do you live with?
Right now, I moved back in with my mom since I broke my arm.
Your mom's supporting you?
No, I support myself. My mom has paid my car. I pay my own car. Everything's paid for.
Serious? How much do you have in savings?
Right now I have $8,000.
Is that from the car accident?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
I will sign your informa pauperis for filing fee only, and I will make sure that hasn't been filed yet. So you can get this filed, but any future fees, you'll have to reapply, okay? So I will put here, filing fee only, just for this once. By then, maybe you should have, you'd have a job and can afford to pay future filing fees, but I will sign this. And she can go file this downstairs. This is exhibits, counsel. She doesn't have. It's like medical records, birth certificate, Who's Dr. Harden, Hardy?
Sasha went to me who delivered my son.
Okay. No, who's Greg Harder?
Are you talking about the other court?
Psychologist Craig Hart, yeah.
He was arrested for child abuse and neglect. That is a, was it court order that she
It's from 11 years ago?
Yes, I'm just showing. She's trying to bring up my past CPS cases, which me and Sean agreed in July would not, we weren't going to bring together. So I don't think it's right that she could use that against me. But I also wanted to show that she has her own CPS cases.
When's the last time Grandma saw the child?
On Thanksgiving Day. She had him all night. Yeah, all night. She even, I even got text messages, her thanking me.
And before that?
September 29th. She went to court on the 4th. I kept letting her see him. I was giving her 3 days a week. And every time I went there, she would say things like, when am I going to see him again? When am I going to see him again? I said, I don't know right now. She said, do I have to take you to court? And I said, look, here's a couple weeks with my son. And then less than a week later, she went to the courthouse over there and told the judge that I belong in prison, I'm a horrible mom, she'll be a witness for the prosecutor to a crime that was actually dismissed. And okay. I told her then that she's going to have to bring me to court now.
All right, Ms. Grigsby, this is your motion.
Yes, Judge. So, as
have a seat, Mom. Have a seat. Okay.
You know, from the long history between the parents, you had actually ordered supervised visitation back in April, and they were in place till August when Dad passed away. Since then, Grandma, who's been a consistent part of Preston's life, she did try to work with Mom, and Mom, she has told her from...
What I'm interested in is... Right before Sean passed away, he was filing some kind of motions, and he said it had something to do with custody or her visitation. Were there any new incidents that arose, something like another arrest?
It was a domestic violence in, I believe, April of 2017 between Mom and someone else, which she's saying that was...
That's dismissed.
Okay.
But I'm not.
Do you have proof that it's dismissed?
No, they say that when you look it up online, it should show up dismissed.
What court? What judge?
Judge Kearns, 6D, and what was the other question? I'm sorry.
I want to know about your criminal case, so...
It's just dismissed. They say they dismissed it.
Should be in these records here?
They said it should show up like that, or gone.
All right. Continue, counsel.
Yes, Judge. So that was the reason that you had ordered supervised visitation for Mom. Grandma's really concerned because Mom cut off her access to Preston, and yes, she did let her see him on Thanksgiving, but then after that just stopped altogether, made all types of accusations of, and Mom can go into that, which were very offensive, and since then had said, I'm not going to let you see Preston unless we go to court and the judge orders.
What's your date of birth?
2/17/84.
Okay.
And Grandma has been a part of Preston's life from birth. She was there.
But Sean had filed something.
Yes, he had filed to...
Oh, because of the DVRS.
Yeah, because of that.
N-K-N-C-H. And you said that Mom was on... Hang on, I'm with her. Was on supervised visitations?
And it's an order.
That all changed when... Okay. There are no open cases. There it is. April 6, 2017, battery, not guilty, case is closed. April 1, 2017, is that speeding? Yeah. Guilty of a speeding ticket. It was adjudicated on October 3rd. The battery case was not guilty, case closed. And I can't have, I don't have access to court minutes, but not guilty, case closed on December 6th at 10 a.m. Mm-hmm. They closed the case out. So no conviction of domestic violence. Was the child present when you were arrested?
No.
The child was with Sean?
Yes.
And prior was 2013, 2012, and 2005. Yes. So
there were a couple of CPS cases
well.
Since court?
No, not since then.
I'll do a double check on that. I'll order CPS, if any. Since the last time we ordered, I'd have to check my emails. Okay. Let me ask you this. These two can't sit in a room downstairs or separate rooms and try to work out a schedule?
Can I tell you why not?
Okay, hold on, hold on.
Your Honor, can I speak to you, please? Just to answer that question.
Sure.
Okay, I tried to trust her with her word when we came in here the last time right after my son passed.
I know, everybody was crying and it was a very solemn
and it was
proceeding.
Very emotional and I was overcome with grief.
Sure.
And
hold on. I think FMC would be good, the mediation.
Separate rooms is fine or sit in a room. Mediation.
Well, can I please explain why I do not want her to see him or be alone with him?
You can?
She came in this room last time, and she told you that he died of an asthma attack.
I never
he
said that.
Die.
She didn't.
Hold on. Excuse me, it's on record. She told me he died of an asthma attack, which is what I told you she said. Okay? My son was present. He died of a drug overdose. Okay? She told my four-year-old son to...
Did you have the death certificate?
I have it right here.
Can I see a copy of it?
She told my son, my four-year-old son, to tell me that he wasn't present. My son had come to me crying, asking me why he had to keep lying about it.
He was not there.
He was there. That's what he told me. How would he know anything about it?
He didn't know anything. Because you told him.
I stopped. I had to go to Social Security. Well, I was at Social Security.
Get a copy of this for the lawyer. It does verify. I don't know if Grandma's aware of that.
She knew. She's the one that was trying to cover it up. She's the one that found him. Okay? For her to make my son lie like that is crazy. That's crazy. My son had to come to me and tell me that the way that he told me, he's 4 years old. He told me, and this is exactly how he said it, something was wrong with Daddy's arm. So Daddy took a shower. When Daddy came out, it didn't help it. So the monsters came and took him away and turned him into a baby. And that's how my 4-year-old explained it to me.
Judge, I believe my client wants to explain how that happened.
Not only that.
Today is not a trial.
Okay, Your Honor, the
okay,
child
today is today's your temporary motion. Okay. Are you, counsel, aware of any precedent or prior case law that how the court should approach this? Because we only have one parent. And as long as the parent is not deemed unfit, they are fit to have custody. And that's a different standard than just a standard custody battle between a mom and a dad because of the hierarchy in our statutes that a parent, a fit parent, would have sole legal, sole physical custody, which is what she has. To change custody, I'm not aware of any precedents that says that we have to meet, and I think there could be some applicability of that case, Ellis versus Carucci, which would be a material change of circumstances affecting the welfare of the child. And your position would be obviously that mom is a risk or a danger to the child, and she can't take care of a child, just give the child basic necessities. One of your arguments I would take it is that she doesn't have a job, stable employment, residence, environment, all that. I get that. So if that's going to be your position, then do I treat this as a custody case? It is a custody complaint, or do I treat it as a grandparents' visitation rights case?
We're requesting, so the way I filed the complaint, it's for custody or in the alternative.
Or in the alternative. Okay.
We're asking for custody first. If you were to deny that request, then we're asking for grandparents.
So one last time, I'm going to ask you, you are of the position that grandma should have zero contact, or you, you're not opposed to grandma having contact?
No.
But why would you want it supervised, Alyssa?
Because my son came to me also, and she told him that I killed his father. She's telling this to my 4-year-old son. The things that my son is saying to me is crazy. And I don't want her to influence him in that way. She needs somebody who is an adult that's not going to... She, I actually have She did it at the
school. He's four. When's he going to be five?
Sorry, in June 25th, 18.
So at this point, all I can do right now is, one, I'm not taking sides in this case. Number two, I am familiar with the history with you and Sean. Number three, I'm going to gather information to see, as we proceed, what kind of orders I can make until, if this isn't resolved, it's going to go to a trial. It's going to go to a trial because it's a first-time contested case. I'm just trying to figure on my mind if it's a custody trial or it's a grandparents' visitation. And they're arguing both ways. So either you and the grandma are going to resolve it. No. Listening to your concerns, I will issue, and I've done it in the other case, I believe, I think I'm pretty sure I did, a behavior order. Everybody's going to act civil towards each other. They're not going to badmouth anybody in both sides of the family to the child. And your concerns about grandma, and I get a lot of she said, saying things disparaging you to the child, with the she said, you know, it's hard for me to figure out who's telling the truth, but the behavior order should cover that. It says we're not allowed to badmouth any adults on both sides of the family to the child. The behavior order does more than that. It's 4 pages long, and everybody's going to abide by that. I know this case, the other case, is a long, contentious history, but let me recommend this. We'll order you guys to go to mediation, but I will do a temporary Band-Aid order with this behavior order in place. I cannot give Grandma any holidays because this hasn't even been decided yet. But I'm I make a finding the grandma has been a babysitter of the child and has been involved with the child since birth, and that the paternal side of the family originally had primary custody. Now, the death certificate, it says the dad died of a drug overdose, so how does that make me feel? I gave him custody of a child, and he's doing illegal drugs, so, yes?
I want to show you something.
It's not Grandma's fault, but your son, he essentially lied to me about him taking care of the child, and I don't know if you were aware of that, Grandma.
You know what, Your Honor?
They found cocaine. I'm going to make a record. They found cocaine. They found heroin. Heroin, very dangerous. Very dangerous.
I agree.
Too much of it. Look what it does to you.
I know. And it was just like he wasn't doing that all the time. He did that because of some circumstances that happened to him.
Poor choices.
I don't want her to hear.
Poor choices, ma'am. Alyssa.
I have the death certificate as well.
I'm talking. Poor choices on his end, and you know you can't have.
I agree with you.
It was either Preston or drugs. Take your pick. You're a grown adult. And he did that, and I'm not there 24/7. Right. Not your fault. You didn't know. Maybe you did. Maybe you didn't. But it makes me nervous that if it was a regular thing, and I will never know. I wasn't watching Sean 24/7. Well, he's taking care of the kid by himself. And what if he's high? And what if he overdosed and the kid's just crawling around the living room floor? That would have been a potentially dangerous situation, but I'm not here to, I'm not here to drag his name through the mud and all that. It is what it is. It's sad. People with drug addictions, sometimes they can't get over it. Okay.
And just if I could ask for one.
Yeah, you're not on any drugs, are you, Mom?
No.
Okay.
She's
what
on
was
those
the last time we drug
morphines and all those.
What was the last time we drug tested you?
The last time I was drug tested was the last time we were in here. We both drug tested each other.
Negative?
Both, yes.
Well, no, she has oxycodone, roxycodone.
At the left side of the file.
And morphines. Remember you made a ruling on that? Oxycodone, roxycodone, morphine, Vicodin, whatever she takes for her problems that
I
she gets prescribed.
Preston in preschool? I'm going to review that.
No, actually, that's what I wanted to ask.
wanted to talk to you about. I was actually getting ready to move to Washington when she followed me up there, and when I realized that she was trying to file this, she's saying that I'm running off, so I came back here so I could prove to you that I am not on drugs. I am not trying to run away from you guys, and these accusations that I was on drugs when he was born is completely wrong.
Were you on any narcotics or prescription drugs?
I stopped taking them for this, just to take the drug test for you. But if I'm going to get my, if I'm going to be forced to cut my hair, then I think she should reimburse me for it.
You're not asking for a drug test, are you? Okay.
No, I'm not paying for a drug test.
Yeah, ATI. Look for ATI tests. Give me a second. July 2016. We got some tests on Mom. And so that was July last year. Yes, she had the oxymorphone, hydromorphone, hydrocodone painkillers, but they were consistent with a prescription from her doctor. So prior to that, that's all I had. I don't know if I had any on Dad. That might have been way back. So...
We went back and forth on the drug testing.
Yeah. Okay. You retain the temporary sole legal, sole physical custody. That's the label because you're the remaining parent. I'm assuming, and I've inquired about drugs. I've inquired about the violence and her case being closed out. Alcohol. We don't have an alcohol problem. The only thing is your environment, but environment to a degree means you can put a roof over Preston's head, you can feed him, clothe him, and provide his education.
I've been staying there since February. I've been a resident there. But
contact. The history of the contact. It's not like somebody just walking in the blue. This is a grandma who's been involved with the child since birth and was a previous babysitter. There are no disqualifying factors as to her having no issues with drugs, alcohol, or violence. We had a long talk about the CPS case, but that is over a decade ago, and they haven't had any run-ins with the law or CPS, have you?
No, I haven't, Your Honor, and the case that she submitted on me was not guilty.
Okay. How long ago was that, over a decade?
Yes.
We checked that already, but I'm going to get updated records on Preston. Are there any other minor children?
No.
Grandchildren? Okay, how about your grandchildren? Any minors left?
I have an 11.
Girl? How old was that girl? She over 18 now?
Oh, my daughter? No, she's 20 now.
Oh, okay. But see, that's how long I've been on the case. When we talked about her, she was like 15.
Right, yes. But I do have a couple of other grandkids, an 11-year-old with Sean's son. He lives in Texas, and a 8-month-old.
Okay.
And I wanted to show you this picture of Preston's ears, that the drugs she did have deformed him. One is shorter than the other.
Is that going to wait, Ms. Grigsby?
What's that?
What's with the picture?
She's saying he's deformed because one ear is bigger than the other. I can show you pictures of Sean. They're identical. So she's.
It's not any evidence of abuse, is it?
No.
Otherwise, CPS would have. These people.
No, she's saying I was doing drugs when I was pregnant. Except
okay.
That's why I gave those.
I already ruled you retain the sole legal, sole physical custody, but I think in the best interest of the child, that some Band-Aid order for interim contact.
So I have to stay here?
In terms of the, no, I can't tell you where to go, and I can't tell you where to live, and you have the sole custody of the child, but I am going to allow contact. So if you move, you'll have to fly the child down, or somebody got to go pick up the child. Where's Preston now, here in town?
He's here, yeah.
Still here?
I was going to move on the 7th of December.
Okay. Until we get to trial, and I will set it now and lock it in, trial will be one day, first available July or August.
August.
And we will meet again sooner because we're going to have 90 days of the mediation. But one week a month would be sufficient until we get to trial. So if you want Grandma to start her week now, we can start her week, and then child would be living up in Washington State. You have to disclose your address where the child can be, where the child's going to be staying. You have family out there?
I have a job waiting for me.
Okay. Where are you going to live in Washington State?
I have a lot of friends and family out there. It's Longview, Washington, 1210 and a half, Commerce Avenue, Apartment C, Longview, Washington, okay. 98632.
Is that on your paperwork, or you need to do a change of address? Because we need to know where to mail you court stuff.
Yes, I do. I told her where I live so she can serve me, and she called the cops on me and sent them over there.
I just asked you a simple question. Is that on your paperwork?
I have to give my son to her for a week at a time.
1 week per month. Yes,
week,
until we go to trial. Because you move out of town. If it was you're going to stay here in town, you know, a couple weekends a month, 2 weekends a month, that would have been 4 days. But because you move out of town, I have to bunch it in all at once, so give her a week. Yes.
Is she going to pay for all this?
She can pay for this because she lied to you and said she was going to continue. Let me see. Then she, because she's afraid that Preston loves me more than her. Because he's always saying he wants to come with me. He doesn't want to go back to her. And yes, I did send the cops out there.
I can't deal with the finger pointing about you pay for it. No, you pay for it.
I got the text messages.
I'm giving you contact. But if you can't afford it, then...
She can bring him to me. I can't afford it. I'm disabled.
Split the cost for it. Split the cost, but it costs tickets to have a chaperone.
But she can bring him to me.
No, I don't have to.
Okay.
He's my son.
I am.
Both of you.
Thank you, Martin.
No, I'm calling the police.
That's the third warning. The child is here now. You'll have your 1 week, and then she'll come back and retrieve the child in a week. And then you'll have your 7 days in January and February, but I'm not your bunny tree or your bank, so I'm going to order that you both split the costs for the transportation.
I'm talking about
it. And it's not cheap. I know that.
I have something.
In order for you to ensure that you get your child and her to comply and not violate any court orders, you have to go get the child in wherever, Seattle Airport. And then she, in order for her to get her child back, she'll have to come down and pick up the child 1 week later. Okay? The week will be designated as, where are we now, in the third week? So it'll start with the third, this is second week, isn't it? Let me see. Second Friday of every month to run for 7 days. This is second Friday? This is second Friday coming up. Second or third Friday, roughly. I'll designate second Friday, except if it falls on a holiday, it'll move to the third Friday because Grandma would not be entitled to any of the holidays right now until they talk downstairs. You can do the mediation by phone since you moved out of state. I need you to fill out a change of address, and you'll exchange the child today since the child is here, and you are going to retrieve the child a week later.
Happening.
And, excuse me, ma'am?
I'm not going to allow you to give my... She's saying that, telling my son that he's... I murdered him. You're not even going to... You're just gonna...
Okay, you obviously don't listen in court. I issued a behavior order, and I'm directing both sides of the family not to disparage any other family member to the child. That's an order.
Stop talking.
Excuse me?
I'm looking out for the best interest of my son.
Are you defying my court authority, ma'am?
Really? I do not want to see my
I think you should stop talking at this point because you're becoming very disrespectful in the courtroom. This is not your kitchen or your living room.
Okay.
With your attitude and those statements that came out of your mouth, you're in direct contempt of the court. That means up to 25 days in jail. Take you in handcuffs now. And your child, I'll give her the temporary custody till you get out on the 24th day. You'll come back to my courtroom. Now, either you're going to cooperate in the courtroom and be civil, or you continue to be disrespectful to me.
I'm not trying to be disrespectful.
I think you have a problem with authority. Look at your criminal record. How many courts you've been in? North Las Vegas? City of Las Vegas? Justice Court?
All dismissed.
You talk to the other judges like this?
Yes, I have. especially Judge Kearns.
Well, I'm not Judge Kearns. I've been a judge for 17 years on this bench, and I've never seen anybody so disrespectful.
Because I'm looking out for my son?
And you still keep talking. I've issued my court order. You violate the court order, contempt of court, and you can sit in jail until you are compelled. You will purge out. I'm issuing a direct contempt of court. Other sanctions stayed. I'm going to hold it over your head if you don't turn over the child today and give her the 1 week. You come back in a week and retrieve your child. Or you stay in Nevada until this case is over.
I'll stay in Nevada right now.
If you stay in Nevada, then I'm going to convert it to 2 weekends a month. 2 weekends a month. You're free to hire an attorney, but I'm holding this over your head. This is your purge clause pursuant to a recent Nevada court case. You have a purge clause. Purge clause is to cooperate with my court order, comply, and follow. If you thumb your nose at my court order, violation, contempt of court, and then I will impose the sanctions. I have to make a record. I have to follow the law. Okay, she's staying in town, so the 2 weekends, this weekend, and then the alternating weekend, every other weekend. It'll be Friday, pick up at, I'll do it daylight hours, 4 o'clock until Sunday at 4 o'clock. Temporary without prejudice. And you can go get a lawyer for the next court hearing. You will not permanently remove the child from the state of Nevada until this case is resolved. This is what you're telling me, that you're going to stay here because it's expensive to go keep flying and picking up Preston. My order would have been split the cost since I'm not taking sides here. I will get you to trial as soon as possible. We'll have them go to mediation if these two cool off and figure something out. But I'm not here to give you legal advice. I'm not your lawyer. Go speak with a lawyer. We'll go with separate rooms in the DV vote protocol.
So Friday?
Friday, 4 o'clock?
Can it be 5:30?
I'll make it here. Yes, I'll make it here at the courthouse because we got video cameras. Friday at 5:30 and at the gate in the security scanners till Sunday at 5:30.
Drop them off here too. She's more than 15 minutes late. That I don't have to sit here and wait for hours because
You will get on the Talking Parents app. I don't know if I put Sean and you on that. And so now you'll have one with Grandma, and then barring any flat tire issues, if you just a no-show, put a 30-minute window, and then you can go home with Preston. Don't be late. Okay.
She's already disobeyed the court order twice before with Sean.
I don't know. We'll save that all for trial, but you have what you have, and she'll cooperate and comply, or I'm going to impose these sanctions, including the direct contempt for her behavior in the courtroom.
Thank you, Your Honor. I appreciate it, and so does my family, my daughters.
Well, there is no father anymore, so I believe that's in the best interest of the child for the child to maintain some ties with the paternal side of the family.
Yes, and all my children, okay. They work for me.
No drug test. Dates are set.
I'm sorry, Judge, what dates?
And, Mom, you still do retain the permanent sole legal, sole physical custody. I'm leaning more towards the grandparents' visitation rights rather than taking custody from the mom unless something pops up. But I don't see any issues with drugs, alcohol, or the violence because of no criminal cases. I know what Sean filed at the last time. We never got to the conclusion of it, and she just had a recent court date. A week ago, December 6th, so she was cleared of that. It's very hard to take away a custody unless they're unfit, and that's different than the usual, you know, fighting custody battles. This is a mom, she gets priority, and then grandparents, next level, the best they can ask for is visitation rights. So this isn't really going to be a custody case. It doesn't sound like to me. As long as you're able to care for Preston. and provide a stable environment for him. Okay, one more order I have to sign.
Return hearing will be March 21st at 10 a.m.
Okay.
Calendar call will be July 25th at 9:30. Trial will be August 23rd at 9:30.
Now, I'm not making any specific orders on phone calls or video calls. I'm going to leave it up to Mom and the Grandma to work it out, and we'll see if Grandma gets any of these calls between now and trial. I expect cooperation. You don't have to dial every day, but a couple times a week so Grandma can continue maintaining a bond. I wanted to order one more thing, and that was you made copies already. 1 hour observation, I'm going to have Grandma pay for. She's going to get in a room with Preston. You'll make an appointment at the mediation, and they're going to be observed. And we'll see if the comfort level of Preston with the Grandma. Okay? This says you have to bring the child for the appointment. That is a direct order. And they'll just spend an hour and report. The people downstairs will report back to me.
Is it during her visitation time? Or
should I do one for Mom, too? No, for Grandma.
Do one for Mom as well, please.
You don't have a problem with that, do you?
Absolutely not.
Okay, so you'll be observed for 1 hour as well.
Is she paying for it?
I will waive your fee, Mom. And Grandma got to pay whatever they charge her.
Why do I have to pay when I'm indigent?
Okay.
I will. The first thing that she said when her son died is how much.
Does she have an informal pauperis?
We didn't file one, but I can't.
She shook it for her.
Oh, hold on. She had money to hire you. Are you doing this pro bono?
No, yeah.
They hired you? And you can't pay $50?
Well, I'll pay the $50. I'm sorry, Jan. I thought it was like hundreds of dollars. No, $50 on that. We should get that.
Okay.
I was working, Your Honor, in the state of California, but
I'll put it here. Paternal grandmother. No more. You can explain this at the window with them. Judge Ma said that you're not going to charge me no more than $50.
Thank you, Your Honor, and thank you for the visitation rights as well.
I've waived yours just this one time for this. Okay, since Grandma's pursuing this case, that's the difference why. Your request. But they won't charge you more than $50 for the whole thing, the mediation and the 1 hour observation. Make sure they know that downstairs. It'll go in the court minutes.
And is it just once?
Mom won't be charged anything but her time to come in here and do the mediation. And did I write Grandma and Mom 1 hour observation? Mom's fees waived, and Grandma's going to be charged no more than $50 for the whole deal. Oh, I'm sorry.
All right.
And paternal grandmother. This, can you explain to them, is separate 1 hour observations, obviously? Separately. And I'll put an arrow. Okay, they're not going to be observed together. This Mom and Preston, Grandmom Preston. That's all for now. Miss Grigsby, please prepare the order. Case D560076, Colt Plummer. Counsel, your appearance and bar number. Oh, why is Grandma not present?
I'm not sure. She
okay.
Knew
that. Are you here? You're Alyssa?
Yes.
Who's with you?
My mom.
She's not a party to the case, so she'll have to sit behind you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes. Only parties and lawyers are allowed at the table. Thank you. All right, let's swear you in, Alyssa.
Please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give in this action shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
Okay. Did you get your letters from mediation? So you did show up, but just no agreement, which means we have to do a trial.
She wants full custody.
Okay. And then we finally got the one-hour observation in. This literally landed on my desk. Have you had a chance to read it? Let me just go to the summary session. So a child's comfortable with grandma. That's okay. So in the meantime, when we go to trial, I'm going to double check with you guys. Calendar call is July 25th at 9:30. We should have given you a piece of paper on that. Trial is August 23rd at 9:30. You are guaranteed to go, stack one. And we're going to do the, it's either going to be a custody slash visitation rights or no visitation. So obviously, we won't know what the final outcome is. But your pretrials are due on or before July 25th. Pretrial form, you filed them before? No. We'll give you the blank form.
Okay.
We'll give you the blank form. This will be due July 25th. You got some time.
And did she have
will you bring in the trial?
Who?
Yes. You, your mom, just yourself?
I'm going to bring all the people that know me.
Okay. So I'm going to check on you at the end of July. You got to have your final list of who you're bringing and what you're bringing, your exhibits and your witness list, okay?
I'm going to go to the Legal Aid Center. I've got a new job. I'm a caregiver now.
Okay.
And I'm working every single day because I'm taking somebody else's hours. But right. When I get done with that, I'm going to go to Legal Aid.
Yes, so make sure you arrange these dates ahead of time with your boss so you can get off work on these dates.
Okay. Can I ask for something else be added to the behavior order?
And Judge, I did do the order for direct contempt that you had requested that I bring to.
Yes, we'll combine that for trial. Do you have the order?
I have.
Please approach. What's your question on the behavior order?
She called CPS on me. She said that I was burning him with cigarettes and.
All right. Since you brought that up, I will go get the records. But what's your request? No calling of CPS? I can't.
I mean, she's calling CPS and making up completely. It's making my life okay. So hard.
And
more stuff that I have to do.
I can't make an order to say you can't call CPS, but if you call and it's unfounded, then we'll take that up at trial. Or you can subpoena the CPS worker and saying, time's being wasted. Our time's being wasted.
Yes.
Or it was a legitimate call.
She said she's going to close the case. I spoke to her
but
yesterday.
The behavior order still stands.
Okay.
And that'll remain to be seen at trial. But I will order the records. If you want to take a look at the records, first you can get your own at the office, their office. If you want to take a look at it in camera or pick it up personally from Chambers if you're an attorney. We'll have that available, in a week. Okay.
I sent him over to her with shoes on and clothes on. She sent him back without any on. She said it belonged to
okay. I'll fix that. So whatever the child has dropped in, the clothes and the shoes will be exactly returned, and the clothes will be washed and clean and returned in the same outfit so we don't get clothes
matter.
And shoes missing.
I just don't want to come home with no shoes on.
Right. No, but that's my order. That's a standard order. Counsel knows.
Thank you.
No order would be necessary, though. We'll just I'll put in the court minutes, return them in the same outfit, and make sure not barefoot.
Thank you.
Okay. If the child came with shoes,
yes.
Child go back with shoes, preferably the same shoes it came in.
Yes.
Anything else? Okay. And she's going to try and get a legal aid attorney. The order, do I have it? Did I sign it?
Yes.
And it's detailed?
Yes.
Okay, well, no. I want to file in open court so she served. Is this the order show cause?
Yes.
If it's in the nature of order show cause, the list is standby. We're going to serve it, and then you talk about it if you get an attorney, but you'll have to defend yourself at trial on this or
Judge,
put your case.
What we had put in there was, because at the last hearing she said she was going to do the visits, but the visits have been going as.
Okay.
Well, so I don't think that'll be an issue.
I've been giving him extra time, a lot of extra time.
Are you keeping a diary or a journal?
It's all in text messages, but I can do it that way.
If you summarize it for trial, how much extra time, that may be helpful to me.
Does it count? count if I'm giving the kids the time too, per kid?
I can't give you legal advice, but I do want you to keep track of the time or extra time that you've been giving Grandma.
Okay.
Okay. It wouldn't hurt to organize it for me on trial. It's a few months away.
Because they live together, but I have her kids come get them, so she's seeing them too, is what I mean.
Who's they?
Her daughters.
Oh, yes.
So I they are the ones picking
Sean's
them up.
Sean's sisters.
Huh?
Sean's sisters.
Yes.
Okay. I'd suggest keep a diary journal on a calendar.
And I know she's not here, but I need to change the dates.
For
pick up and drop off.
Because of your new job?
Yes.
That's an emergency matter. What do you...
Is that something that you guys have discussed? And not
I've tried to talk to her. She won't talk to me.
Is Grandma work?
No.
She's flexible then.
Yes.
What day would you request?
I'm
what do you, what does she have now?
Weekends. I'm asking that it's the weekdays. Like Thursday, Friday. She has Saturday, Sunday.
Right now she has every weekend?
Every other weekend.
Every other.
Yeah, I think it's like Friday at 5:30 to Sunday.
Right.
At
It's 6:30 to 6:30 on Friday to Sunday. So I'm just asking that it's weekdays because
Grandma don't work?
And she doesn't work. But my mom doesn't work on the weekends, so she can watch him on the weekends, and I'm literally working every single day. So I can't.
But when you're not, you'd like to spend.
So I'm just asking to switch it to a weekday, so I'm not paying that much on daycare.
You want to shift it? Grandma don't work. Maternal grandma don't work.
I'm not sure about her schedule, but I think...
I did speak to her.
May not be, it may not be a problem.
Probably, I don't foresee it as a problem, but let me just talk to my client and then I can just get back to you.
So, and because I spoke to her daughter tomorrow, and I said, well, what I could do is do Wednesday.
All right. If paternal grandma's okay with it, Miss Grigsby will do the order.
Yes.
You'll sign a stipulation with the lawyer to change the date so you have something in writing. I will... tell you right now, if you guys clash and you can't agree on the shift of days, it makes sense to me. Paternal grandma's not working. She's more than available, and then mom would like to get her weekends back. If other alternative potential order would be we could give her, instead of every other weekend, 2 weekends a month, give her to 1 weekend, and then one she'll have to take during the week as a compromise. But check with grandma. If you need a hearing on that, you'll have to file a motion.
Okay.
Mom will have to file a motion.
I'm hoping we can start.
If Grandma won't budge, but to me, it kind of makes sense. And
it sounds reasonable.
I'm hoping
so. Okay.
Today.
Yeah, the lawyer knows.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, 7:30
is probably. Okay. That's all for today.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Come on up.
I won't see you till July 25th. Yep.
July? Okay.
July 25th, 9:30. That's your calendar call. You must be here.
Could you just give me something that printed there?
Judge Grandma's here.
I've been out there sitting. No one came for me. And I'm
coming up. Stop.
Sorry.
If we could discuss the visitation.
Okay.
Let your lawyer catch up with you. Okay, we didn't do much. Just let your lawyer catch up with you. Go ahead, talk to your client. I'm glad you follow along very well, Martin. Okay. Which case is this?
Colt.
Case D560076. Well, I have it under Marianne Colt, paternal grandmother. And Alyssa Plummer, counsel, your appearance and bar number.
Good morning, Your Honor. Barrett Grigsby, bar number 10308, appearing for
Okay, swear the parties in.
Please raise your right hands. Do you and each of you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give in this action shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Thank you.
Ms. Grigsby, you have a motion to withdraw. Are you staying for the hearing or you want to be released?
I would request to withdraw at this time.
Okay, do you have any opposition to that?
No.
Okay, so you're released from the courtroom. Do you have an order or just submit one? Okay, thank you. Motion
but
to withdraw. Yes?
I'm going to hire her back when I have the money.
Okay, thank you. All right, but she's released for today.
Yes.
All right, she'll submit an order to withdraw and you can hire her back at any time.
Thank you, ma'am.
And we swore them in, right? Okay. This is our calendar call. We're getting ready for the trial. I'm just trying to refresh my memory. Is grandparents visitation or things have changed because a new event had occurred? And mom was legal 2000. You ended up in our mental health court. They found that you were competent, I guess, and so they did not involuntarily commit you. Did they hire an attorney for you? Or you?
Yes, they did. Romero?
I know that a doctor, Romeo?
Romeo Perez? Perez, I'm sorry.
Yes. He was just here earlier.
Oh, yes.
Okay. So he represented you and Dr. Puglini and another lady doctor,
we
I guess.
We didn't even have to go that far.
Huh?
We didn't even get that far. They just...
There was a report submitted. So did they interview you?
Yeah. Well, they interviewed me.
Because they had to report back to the judge and see if you were mentally competent.
Yeah. Well, they all went in and said that the Romeo, Mr. Perez, never had to come into court because they released...
There wasn't any basis to
right.
commit you
right.
to the mental hospital.
Right.
From what I read, you took some Tylenol PM pills, and your roommate called the legal 2000 on you.
Right, I took them, and he came in.
Where was the child, Preston?
He was with her.
No, he was not. I had given him back to her on Sunday night.
It happened on Friday.
Stop.
Okay.
Yeah. This happened on Friday.
One at a time.
I'd have to review the records when she got taken to the hospital.
Okay, yeah.
So we don't even know if it's Friday or...
May I please let you know what happened?
Let me confirm the date, though.
Okay.
It should tell me here. I do have the court minutes from the mental health court. Case M-12-140769. There was a prior case in 2012. This got reopened. And the hearing was on June 8th. And it looked like here, based upon the evidence presented, the petition to commit mom is denied and case was dismissed. Hospital will begin the discharge process. You were at Southern Nevada, Rawlings, Neil?
Yeah.
Southern Nevada Adult Mental Health Center? Case was closed. Okay. The petition was filed by the hospital. Typically, it's the hospital. And it was filled out, because they're filled out on the spot. Looks like on June 4th, yes, and 4 days later they held the court hearing. Ms. Clark, what date was June 4th? June 3rd.
June 3rd was a Sunday.
It was a Sunday.
It was at about 1 o'clock or 1 o'clock in the morning.
Where was Preston supposedly on Sunday?
On Sunday until 6:30 he was with me, and then the mother over there, her mother...
Yeah, she got picked up at 6:36 in the morning.
Right. Okay, so Preston,
about right?
Yeah. Preston was with me, but he went back that evening at 6:30 p.m. to grandmother over there.
You dropped off.
Yes,
Did you know she got taken in legal 2000?
No, I did not know. I would have kept him because they did temporarily.
That's probably right.
Give him
so, Grandma, your mom took care of Preston the day you went to the hospital.
You went in the morning.
Marianne didn't know. Marianne just knew to drop off with your mom at 6:30 that night.
Right.
Okay, we're all on the same page.
Okay, and then she caught a CPS case.
She stayed in the hospital probably for 4 days.
And they kept me in there to a 72-hour hold is what it was.
That's a lot.
And then the child was in the hospital with her, and the nurses called CPS on her. Because I had no idea until CPS called me of what was
okay, that could be.
I actually already had a CPS case because she called them.
That's not true.
Before that, yes, it
is.
There will be records on that.
Yes.
Okay,
so it was already open. Someone at the hospital called. The child was there. CPS called me, and I received custody in an emergency situation.
Okay, so I have some stuff here. There's a lady named Dodge Slagle, I think it's a female, the doctor of osteopathic medicine, the commitment evaluation, I'm reading the report, 36-year-old female, admitted on the L2K, legal 2000 hold, indicated she had psychosis, was threatening others, cooperative on the unit. Patient states she took 5 Tylenol PM, roommate called for help, denies trying to hurt herself, upset that she was being held. Denies hallucinations. She's paranoid about son's father. She denies thoughts of suicide or homicide. Past use of opioid meds that stopped in January. The son was taken from her custody in 2013. Tylenol level 1.01. Evaluee requested an immediate discharge from the facility. That was mom's request. two prior psych admissions, two prior suicide attempts. Upon admission to the hospital, positive for marijuana, UDS, I don't know what that stands for. Would you know? UDS, okay. Appearance and behavior was cooperative. Good eye contact, no psychomotor disturbance, normal speech rate. Thought processes were goal-oriented. No psychosis, no psychotic thoughts. Okay, no clear diagnosis. This evaluee demonstrates signs and symptoms of a life problem, which does not precisely fulfill the criteria for a psychiatric diagnosis. It is my professional opinion to a reasonable degree of psychiatric probability that commitment criteria are not met in this individual. So, there was no involuntary commitment. It was a 72-hour hold. They must hold a hearing in court in 72 hours. They held the hearing. They dismissed the case. I only say that just to update you guys.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so now I have the CPS records, and I'm not sure if there was any updates on that. We ordered these on July 16th, and do you know if there was an email from Anthony, if there was any summary? Now, we referenced CPS, so let me see if the June stuff, the early June stuff with her, they took the kid away from her, is in here. I do have it. Here's the summary. I got it. On June 4th, CPS received a report. Mom was brought to Mountain View Hospital. Legal 2000 hold, she was intoxicated. I guess they meant the Tylenol. Stated that she was not trying to kill herself. Okay, they mentioned the Tylenol. Alright, let me just cut to the chase and read what they wrote at the very end. This is a conclusion. Case will be open for permanency services. Conduct the safety plan determination immediately unless a present danger plan is in place. Well, who'd they leave the kid with? Child is safe, case closed, discreet. It's recommended the case be closed with no further services offered consistent with DFS. Specifically, as indicated under Mountain, the allegation is unsubstantiated that she abused or neglected the child. The child was obviously not present in the morning that she got taken in, and they said it didn't rise to the level of a petition of abuse and neglect, and they didn't make any findings. Unsubstantiated. Okay. The only thing I'd be left with is what will raise a red flag is she gets into these periods of instability and situations occur. And yeah.
Scary.
I don't know. To grandma it's scary, but I don't know what to make of it.
Okay,
you're supposed to, I deemed you fit to take care of Preston.
I was in my Tylenol. He woke me up and I took Tylenol.
Who woke you up? Your roommate?
My friend, he came in and he woke me up. I had taken some Tylenol PMs. He thought I knocked the bottle over. And
your friend here?
Huh?
Your friend's not here.
He's not here, no.
Your roommate?
He's at work.
What's his name again?
Jeffrey Sumner.
He's just a friend?
He's just a friend.
Jeffrey. Okay. You might have talked about him before.
Yes,
he was very concerned for you.
Call 911. He thought I took a whole bunch of it, and I didn't.
After
the time of PM, and he thought I took.
When the ambulance or police came, did you wake up on the spot, or you don't remember being transported?
I don't even remember because I was. You woke up. I took time of PM to go to bed. I didn't know. I didn't even know what.
Did they try to wake you up at the hospital?
They woke me up at the hospital, and I freaked out because I didn't know what was going on.
And you knew you were going to get Preston back at 6:30 at night. You know what five Tylenol can do to you?
It was the night before on Saturday. And he woke me up.
Okay,
it was
the night before.
Yeah.
And you're thinking it was going to wear off 24 hours when you're going
to
get your child back?
Tylenol PM? I was just going to bed. I have a hard time sleeping, that's all.
You told him five. The bottle doesn't say take five.
Because I was in a lot of pain. It's hard for me to sleep. I'm in a lot of pain. I stopped taking all the narcotics. I'm trying to go green, so I've been smoking weed instead, and I was taking Tylenol PMs. I was taking 120 a month narcotics for my back because of my back problems and the thing that's on my.
Are you on any narcotics now?
No, I stopped taking them in January.
Okay.
I was getting them from the doctor. I've given you proof of that.
That's true.
Did we talk about ordering her Board of Pharmacy records? Did I ask you to go to like CVS, Walgreens, and print out what you?
When he was with his dad. No, well, when he was with his dad. Because that's a whole different case.
Okay. Today is just to check to see if you guys are ready for trial. The big day is going to be the trial. It's going to be August 23rd at 9:30. It is either a grandparent's visitation or, I'm not sure, custody is at issue.
Right. I'd like legal custody because, you know, with so many things going on in her life, this isn't the first time this has happened.
We're just trying to find out today, number one, any emergency. And I have negative on mental commitment. I have negative on CPS, unsubstantiated. Three, unless there's any other emergency, I only discuss emergencies. You could ask for whatever you want at trial.
Yes, I understand.
And you may want to hire your lawyer back for trial. Right. I don't know if you're going to get a lawyer, but I will hear from both sides. And we're coming up around the corner, August 23rd at 9:30, full day, step one, full day, half day.
Well, I'm asking if we can push that out, please.
Let me hear mom first.
Continuances.
Well, I don't know, you might need to raise money to hire your lawyer.
That's what
Why do you want a continuance?
Because they said because it's a different case, I have to do the Ask a Lawyer program, and they were full till the 9th,
mm-hmm.
and then you have to go back to Legal Aid Center.
And you're using them to help you prepare for trial?
Yes.
Okay.
So well, they said that they would need more time to find the lawyer. Because I have to do...
So you're August 23rd?
And also that Sunday after... Okay.
If I leave things the way they are, can you guys hang on until the next trial date?
What do you mean hang on?
Do what you're doing until I get to a final order.
Yes.
And you guys testify.
Yes, and she gave me extra time till Wednesday this week because my grandson is coming Friday.
And that won't make her look bad to work with you and co-care.
I'm trying to work with her.
Okay.
So she's working with me.
That will give you... And if you... Give it a couple more months. If things get better and you guys want to settle up and agree, you can do it at any time.
Well, we were going
right
to
now, I'm out to February, though, guys, and I can only give you a half day now. But if we don't finish, we'll go to another half day.
Okay.
Are you okay with February?
Continuances.
Huh?
That's what she said. I put a motion for a continuance, as a matter of fact. This is it.
But you're all on the same page. We're all on the same page.
Right. Do you
okay.
want this copy?
Give me a minute scheduling order right away. Okay, we'll sign one. All right, Erica here is going to take care of your dates. We'll push out discovery deadlines. Give them pretrial memos. They'll be due on the discovery deadline.
Excuse me, Your Honor.
Yes, ma'am.
One more thing, ma'am. The pickup. She's moved, and I'm like 45
Again?
Minutes from the courthouse.
Yeah.
I got an apartment.
Where are you at? Intersection.
I'm at Sunset and Fort Apache.
I know where that is. Where are you at?
I'm on Rancho here. I actually wanted to turn this in. It's a change of address.
Oh, okay.
Do you
and
have a copy for me?
We'll process. Do you have a copy there? We'll make
a
copy. Martin, process.
Copy, Erica.
Yeah. Okay. Me or you can give the judge.
What intersection? Rancho and?
Lake Mead.
Yeah, I know where that is. Okay.
It's right in front of the Texas Station, off of Texas Station.
Halfway would be like the Red Rock Casino.
Stop.
Or, yeah, halfway would be like the Red Rock Casino.
Yeah.
Where y'all meet up?
I'm not going to have a car anymore.
Well, Red Rock Casino's too far for her. I know that. So I was going to
You ride a bus or you borrow a
car?
You don't have a license.
My car is $530 a month, and now that I got an apartment for me in Preston, I can't afford both. So I'm going to get rid of the car.
Oh, okay. Grandma's going to have to do all the driving, or are you going
to
ride the bus?
I'm
or is your mom
going to
help you, give you rides?
I'm going to work it out, but if you want to change it to like DeMar's house, or if you want
to... No, I want to change it to McDonald's on Sahara and Flamingo. They have cameras in case something happens. And also, the next time I pick the child up, which was 2 weeks later on a Friday, that Sunday, she never showed up to the pickup spot. And then Monday, she called me, right? I hadn't heard
Did
from
she
her.
Make it up to you if you missed any time?
She hasn't made that up to me.
Him.
But listen,
okay, hang on.
I had him that extra day, but the point is she never called nothing.
I'll take that up at trial.
I'm going to drop him off because she calls Monday morning.
Okay.
Any missed time?
No, my apartment got burglarized.
Any missed time, we'll deal with that at trial.
Okay.
The emergency right now is...
The pickup.
Yeah, I know you want Sahara Flamingo. It's not doable
for
mom.
Is that? It's closer to you. Red
She's
Rock,
at Rancho Lake Mead.
Rancho and Lake Mead. Can we go all to
Okay,
Lake
so wait. So
Rancho,
can you
Lake
go
Mead?
To, somewhere on Sahara would be halfway.
That would be good.
No. Or
can you get to, like, Sahara and, like, Rainbow?
That works. That's easier. That's much easier than Flamingo.
Can you get to Sahara?
Okay, then you want that one? Sahara and Rainbow. Okay. So
you're right off the 215 Beltway, aren't
you? Yes, I am.
She's not. But she would have to double back, get on the 95, get on Summerlin Parkway, and then shoot down. But it's all highway.
Yeah.
Well, I don't have, and if you,
I'm driving the car.
And right off the highway would be Red Rock Casino.
Yeah, I like Red Rock Casino.
Because the exits on the Beltway at Lake Mead and there's nothing there. How about Flamingo?
Flamingo?
No, that's closer to her.
If we could do Flamingo, like,
no, Red Rock would be more fair. Halfway. Can you guys meet at the Red Rock Casino?
I think Red Rock's good now that you're talking about. Want to just meet at Red Rock Casino?
Everybody, if you're at Rancho Lake Mead, just hop on the 95 to Summerlin and shoot down south.
But I'm going to be on a bus.
Oh, you're going to be on a
bus? The bus will take you to Red Rock Casino, though. That's definitely a drop-off, right?
She can run up and down Rancho. And
if I'm at work until 5:30, how am I going to get there until 6:30?
You have to.
Right now you're driving, right?
I'm not. I'm giving up my car.
Does your mom have a car?
I was going to give it up tomorrow.
Does your mom have a car?
Yeah, but her car's not very well. It's a lemon.
Oh my gosh.
Are you,
and you're good with the bus, though?
And stuff?
You're good with the bus?
I have no choice. I have no choice.
Preston will be on a bus for an hour.
Or two.
That's what I was trying to get.
Days do you have with Preston?
What days do I have with
him? Why don't we do week on, week off? You only meet each other once a week.
That's a good idea.
What, a whole week? I give her a whole week?
Well, less bus transportation.
Well, then I wouldn't see my son for 2 weeks.
Mom. What are you doing right now?
Every other weekend.
But I want to get
How about half a week?
Every other weekend.
How about 1 week with grandma, skip a week, 1 week with paternal grandma?
Why are we giving her more time?
Because of your
transfer. I have no issue with the bus. I'll take it wherever I have to. Every other weekend is fine by me.
And if it becomes too much,
Red Rock would be halfway between Sunset and Fort Apache and Rancho and Lake Mead.
Yes, affirmative. Yes, Josh.
Yeah, you agree. Red Rock it is, but where in Red Rock you all want to meet?
Just outside where the counters are. Outside by Lucille's or something.
Main entrance of the casino, Red Rock.
Okay, main entrance of the casino.
Is it that hard to get in, or across the street is a Best Buy?
Red Rock would be the good place.
I'll take an Uber if I have to.
Red Rock's a good place.
Yeah, especially she's taking an Uber.
Main entrance, Red Rock. Okay.
There's more than one main entrance.
There's main entrance and south entrance. So the main entrance.
Because she'll see
Lucille's.
Then we just work it out.
The main entrance where Lucille's is located next to the entrance. Lucille's Barbecue.
Well, right, because she'll be able to see.
You'll meet in front of Lucille's Barbecue.
Your Honor, I just want to be adults and work it out together.
Yeah, but if you can't work it out, you meet in front of Lucille's Barbecue.
Okay.
There's a door there. Okay. If it's hot, go inside. It's air conditioned.
Okay.
And you guys know Talking Parents app, right?
Yes.
You're on. Okay.
And you know what?
That'll hold us over. And do you have special provisions for Thanksgiving and Christmas?
No, not yet.
I can't really give it to you, but I can give you around that time so you can still celebrate.
Right.
Will you work it out or file an emergency motion?
Okay,
I'll try and work that out with you.
Yes, Thanksgiving, all the holidays are yours, and she'll have to celebrate around it unless you want to give up some time on the actual holiday. Work it out or file an emergency motion.
Okay, and you know what, Your Honor? If the Red Rock doesn't work for her, if we try it, it doesn't
Talking
work.
Parents, let her know.
Yes, then we will work something out where, as long as I'm on camera, I don't care.
And you confirm it on Talking Parents. Alyssa, you agreed we're going to change the location, and we agree to that, and she's to text you back, I agree.
Okay.
Then it doesn't change until you guys change it again.
Okay, that's fine.
Stand by for your scheduling order and give them pre-trial memos.
Okay.
Martin, we're going to...